Hey friends, it's Brian here, and it's time to work on my F-350. It's a 1990, and I'm in the process of restoring and rebuilding it to put it back to work. So today I'm going to work on the wiring harness on the engine because it's in really lousy condition. Those two little strands apparently are all that's left that come up here to the fuel solenoid. So yeah, we're just a couple of strands away from not running. And then I've got all this shit back here that comes in here, goes all the way around to the back of the engine, and comes up forward. That doesn't make any sense to me, so I'm gonna change it. I'm in the process of relocating the glow plug controller over there, but today I'm gonna be focused on this. So I had started to put, I thought I had a pair of nippers. All right, let me get your wire cutters. All right, so I started to like zip tie some stuff in place, but yeah, that's not gonna be needed because all this shit's gotta be dealt with. Where the hell did I go? Nooks and crannies is what this motherfucker's got. Alright, so we're going to have to fix that because that's just not going to stay reliable. Not sure what this is supposed to be, but whatever it is, it's been decommissioned. And the fuel heater is not part of the equation either. Highly unlikely that this wire carries enough voltage. Man, maybe that's not the fuel. Maybe that's the fuel and water connector or something, because that's not enough. We'll leave that in place for now. But that isn't enough to heat anything. Smoking mess this is. I don't know what that was, but it just broke. It doesn't look like it was in great condition anyway. Bet that's some kind of a knock sensor. I just don't understand this. Why would you do this shit? So what we're going to do is just shorten these, and they're going to come from here straight down. conduct a whole lot of electricity. The first one to get shortened is going to be this. Right, we're going to hang on to that because we'll reuse it. Mostly for its connector. Now the rest of this, I'm going to thread back out of here because this is a simpler and easier way to deal with this. So we've got a couple more things in here, so it does need to stay over here. All right, that's fine. But the majority of this doesn't need to be over here. Tough shit, whatever it is. Let me go see what I busted, and I'm going to rest my hands for a minute. So, this is our green and red wire, which is a start wire, but we're going to go ahead and trim it. We're going to shorten it. And I just don't see why it needs to circle the engine. Is that it runs this, but I have let me get a knife and see if I can penetrate some of this stuff. Oh yeah, this might be easier. Bet you that's the same wire. Let me get a knife. Thank you. there either. So we'll just have to cut it loose. Hell this is, it's tough. So, 3 wires belong to this thing, and then 1 wire goes somewhere else. We need to figure out where the somewhere else actually is. Let my hands rest. I'll be back in a minute. Another quality hillbilly splice. Where this fucking truck ran. I can say is if you've got an old truck like this, probably need to go through the wiring harness. This is the second vehicle I've rebuilt in the last few years, and both wiring harnesses look like shit, just like this one does. You know, there ain't nothing reliable about a wiring harness caked with dirt. All this is an unscheduled stop on the side of the road, waiting to spring itself on you. All this brittle wire with abrasive dirt around it, nothing good's gonna come out of that. Nope. So that is our red and green wire that goes to, makes a loop around there. That's what we wanted to know. Don't know quite what the other two are. Bet one of them is a fast idle solenoid, which is disconnected. Yeah, I probably need to go look at the wiring diagrams. Let me go see if I can find them. I'll be back. Oops. Well, whatever that was going, just got broke.
Ow, damn it.
That was bound to happen. Snipping fun. Quite literally. I don't know what the hell this stuff is, but it's tough. I think it's some kind of heat shrink nylon wire loom. On the one hand, I'm glad they didn't use it anywhere else because shit's tough to get rid of. But man, it sure would have been great protection for the wires. So I finally got all that shit loose, and now I'm extracting the wires that go to it. I mean, this is a lot of extra wire.
God, every bit of this has red and green, is red with a green stripe too. Okay, this is a good 8 feet of wire over there. And then all of these go to the fuel and water sensor. What a pain in the ass. I'll certainly clean this up. So, got two sensors here. Need to go get a vacuum and get some of this dirt out of here. Let me do that. An awful lot of shit on this engine for something that ran great before. Yeah, whatever. Bullshit. I think the hood was off this thing and it sat for a while, at least a season. All sorts of shit up underneath here. Rat crap, leaves, twigs, grass. That shit doesn't blow in. All right. So, I need to go study the wiring diagram and figure out where the abortions are going to happen. And then I need to get to the other end of this, and this needs to come apart anyway, so might as well do that now. All the trouble I've gone to, you didn't think I was going to leave this on here, did you? Hell no. Now. Oh yeah, this connector is fucking came apart. Well, how about that? Yeah, this connector just disintegrated. Oh well, better here in my driveway than on the road. That's where this would have fallen apart. Like seeing all these. This is generally not going to be a good sign. Oh yeah. No, these are all fucked up. Again, it's just a wonder this thing ran. Or rather, that's why it didn't run. Fucking wiring. Fusible link melted? Yeah, just take it. Some of these mysteries are becoming less of a mystery. Was fusible link? just don't understand why there's so much organic shit in places in this truck that it doesn't belong. A lot of places I would expect to see some grass. The wiring harness by the battery is not one of them. Adjusting my little shade stand from Harbor Freight that's keeping me from turning into a crisping sun. A little break. Thank you. Yeah.